Welcome to Grab and Go Info. The balanced weight is a widely used method for imbalanced classification models. It penalizes the wrong predictions about the minority classes by giving more weight to the loss function. In this tutorial, we will talk about how to use balanced weight for the imbalanced multi-label classification. We will cover the following. What is the algorithm behind the balanced class weights for multi-classes? How to use class weights on random forest and logistic regression for multi-label classification? How to interpret the model performance metrics of a multi-label classification model? How to decide whether to use the balanced weights for an imbalanced multi-label classification model? If you are interested in the balanced weight for a binary classification model, please check out my previous tutorial Balanced Weights for Imbalanced Classification. The link for the tutorial will be put in the video description. Let's get started. The first step is to import libraries. The link for the code is in the video description. Make classification from Sclern is for creating the modeling dataset. Pandas and NumPy are for data processing. Counter counts the number of records. Matplotlib and Seaborn are for visualization. Train test split is for creating the training and the validation datasets. Random forest classifier and logistic regression are for modeling. Class weight is for adjusting weights. Classification report is for model performance evaluation. In step 2, we will create a synthetic multi-label imbalanced dataset for the classification model using make classification from the Sclern library. N samples equals 100,000 indicates that 100,000 samples will be generated. N features is the number of predictors. N informative is the number of informative predictors. N redundant is the number of redundant predictors, which are the linear combinations of the informative predictors. N repeated is the number of duplicated predictors, which are randomly selected from the informative and the redundant features. N classes equals 3 means that there are 3 classes in the dependent variable. N clusters per class equals 1 indicates that there are no clusters within each class. Weight specifies the percentage of samples in each class. Class sep indicates how separable the classes are. Larger values spread out the classes and make the classification predictions easier. Random state makes the synthetic dataset reproducible. The output of the synthetic dataset is in NumPy array format. We converted it into the pandas dataframe format. The distribution of the target variable shows that we have about 96% of samples for class 0, 2% of the samples for class 1, and 1% of the samples for class 2. The scatter plot shows the distribution of the data points. In step 3, we will split the dataset into 80% training and 20% validation datasets. Random state ensures that we have the same train test split every time. The train test split gives us 80,000 records for the training dataset and 20,000 for the validation dataset. The training dataset has 77,058 records for class 0, 1,869 records for class 1, and 1,073 records for class 2. In step 4, we will build a baseline multi-label classification model with random forest using the imbalanced dataset. Random forest classifier is the method for the random forest classification model. Random state equals 0 set the seed for the random splits to make them reproducible. N jobs equals minus 1 enables parallel processing. Fit takes an X train and Y train for model fitting. Predict takes an X test for testing dataset prediction. It produces the predicted labels for all the testing dataset records. In step 5, we will use the classification report to evaluate the baseline multi-label classification random forest model performance. The classification report compares the actual and predicted labels for the testing dataset. The output has 2 sections, the top section for the metrics by class and the bottom section for the overall metrics. Precision is the percentage of correct predictions for the predicted class. For example, the precision value of 0.98 for class 0 indicates that 98% of the predicted class 0 are actual class 0. Recall is the percentage of samples captured by the model for the class. For example, the recall value of 0.25 for class 1 indicates that 25% of the samples in class 1 are captured by the model. F1 score is the harmonic value of precision and recall. It is 2 times precision times recall divided by the sum of precision and recall. For example, the F1 score for class 2 is calculated using 2 times 0.97 times 0.67 divided by the sum of 0.97 and 0.67. The result is 0.79. Support for the top section has the count of samples for each class. The bottom section of classification report has the overall metrics across all the classes. Accuracy is the percentage of correct predictions across all classes. Macro AVG is the unweighted mean of a metric across all the classes. For example, macro average for precision is calculated by the sum of 0.98, 0.70, and 0.97 divided by 3, and the result is 0.88. It's a good metric to look at for a balanced dataset because it gives equal weights to each class. Weighted average is the weighted mean of a metric across all the classes. For example, weighted average for recall is calculated by 1 times 0.96321 plus 0.25 times 0.02347 plus 0.67 times 0.01332, and the result is 0.978. It's a good metric to look at for an imbalanced dataset because it takes the weighted average based on class proportion. Support for the bottom section has the total number of samples for the testing dataset. In step 6, we will talk about the algorithm behind the balanced weights. The weights are calculated using the inverse proportion of the class frequencies. The rationale behind it is that the model penalizes more for the wrong predictions on low-frequency classes. And p.uniqueYtrain, return counts equals true gives us the unique label values of all the classes, and their corresponding number of records. The proportion of a class is the number of records of the class divided by the total number of records in the training dataset, and the inverse proportion of a class is 1 over the proportion of a class. We can see that the weight for class 0 is 1.038, the weight for class 1 is 42.804, and the weight for class 2 is 74.557. Sclearn has a built-in utility function classWeight.computeClassWeight for calculating the class weights. ClassWeight equals balanced implements the inverse proportion of classes as the weights for the loss function. Classes takes in the unique values of the classes. Y equals YTrain means that the name for the dependent variable of the training dataset is YTrain. The outputs from compute class weight are 0.34, 14.27, and 24.85. If we multiply each weight by 3, the results are the same as our manual calculation. This is because the formula for compute class weight is n samples divided by n classes times np dot bin count y. There are 3 classes, so the values are 3 times the inverse proportion of each class. In step 7, we will train a random forest multi-class model with the balanced weight. Class weight is a parameter of random forest classifier. The default value for class weight is none, meaning that all classes have the same weight of 1. Class weight equals balanced uses the values of YTrain to automatically calculate the inverse proportion of class frequencies with the formula n samples divided by n classes times np dot bin count y. Class weight equals balanced subsample has the same calculation as class weight equals balanced except that weights are computed based on the bootstrap samples for each tree. Class weight can also take a dictionary or a list of dictionaries for customized weights. We can see that the multi-class random forest model with class weight equals balanced has very similar performance as the baseline random forest model across all the metrics, indicating that the balanced weight does not improve the performance of the random forest model on the imbalanced multi-label dataset. Next, let's try class weight equals balanced subsample and calculate the weights based on the samples for each tree. We got the same performance metric values as the random forest model with the class weight equals balanced option, indicating that the balanced weights do not have a positive impact on the random forest model on this dataset. Is this the case just for the random forest model? Let's try the balanced weights on logistic regression and see if it makes a difference. In step 8, we will build a baseline multi-label classification model with logistic regression using the imbalanced dataset. Compared with the classification report from the random forest model, the logistic regression baseline model has similar performance on class 0 and class 2. For class 1, logistic regression has a precision of 0.97, higher than the random forest baseline model precision of 0.70. Logistic regression has a recall of 0.13, lower than the random forest baseline model recall of 0.25. Logistic regression has an F1 score of 0.24, lower than the random forest baseline model recall of 0.36. We can see that if the goal is to get high precision, the baseline logistic regression has good results across all the classes. But if the goal is to get high recall values, the baseline logistic regression has a poor performance. In step 9, we will train a random forest multi-class model with the balance weight. Class weight is a parameter of logistic regression. The default value for class weight is none, meaning that all classes have the same weight of 1. Class weight equals balanced uses the values of YTrain to automatically calculate the inverse proportion of class frequencies with the formula n samples divided by n classes times np dot bin count y. Class weight can also take a dictionary for customized weights. What a big difference the balanced weights made on the logistic regression. From the classification report output, we can see that the recall values for all the classes are similar. The recall for class 1 increased from 0.13 to 0.73, and the recall for class 2 increased from 0.64 to 0.72. However, the precision for class 1 and class 2 decreased. Therefore, if the goal of the project is to achieve higher recall values, class weight equals balance should be used with the logistic regression model. If the goal of the project is to maximize precision, the default class weight equals none should be used with the logistic regression model. From the comparisons between random forest and logistic regression, and the comparisons between with and without the balanced weights for the loss function, we can see that The balanced weight parameter may or may not improve the model performance, so having a baseline model before applying class weight equals balanced on an imbalanced dataset is important. Depending on the specific goal of the project, using a baseline model can perform a lot better than using a model with class weight equals balanced. For example, in the example above, we saw logistic regression baseline model has over 90% precision for all three classes, but under 20% precision for the two minority classes after applying class weight equals balanced. Different machine learning algorithms can have quite different results for imbalanced multi-label classification. Therefore, it's important to compare different algorithms and pick the model that aligns best with the goal of the project. If you have made it this far, you probably find the information in this tutorial helpful. Please click the like button and subscribe to the channel to get notified when I publish new videos like this. To learn more about imbalanced dataset modeling, please click the YouTube playlist on the screen now. Thank you for watching and see you in the next video.